Dad! You're finally back! Where have you been?
I was entrapped by those Chimera aliens. Marigold, please forgive my disappearance.
It's fine. While you were gone, I met Mom.
You did? But how?
Hello? Hello? Huh? Oh my god! Weird one-eyed guy and an edgelord!
Dad!
Marigold.
Ah! Maybe they were important to these people on this island. Oh well. See? I told you there was another reality where I killed you.
I don't know if I like knowing you've killed me in multiple realities.
Well, that's life. And apparently the end of yours in some. But don't worry. There's probably some realities where you kill me. Oh, you want to see if there's a dimension where we're all chickens?
No, I think I'll pass. So, I see you ended up setting up shop here, but I could have sworn this house belonged to—
All right, time to go back to my Twitch streaming with, huh? Jules, what are you doing in my basement? And why do you have an old man with you?
Hey, don't get the wrong idea. She did not kidnap me and put me in your basement. We just broke in.
You broke in! I thought you were given permission!
Okay. Sorry, Jules. I never thought I'd have to say this, but I'm kicking you out of my house.
But, ugh, that's so embarrassing!
You should have just let me turn him into a chicken.
Ugh, why would you do that?
I mean, I did it to his girlfriend or whatever.
More puny humans must be taken, for our Chimera army must grow! Huh? Wait, you're the prisoner from the mothership. How did you escape?
That will be the least of your worries.
Huh? Dad?
Marigold, what year is it?
2081.
What? No, this can't be.
Haha, got him!
Ignore him. It's been 3 months since your disappearance, but more and more people are being abducted each day.
I see. And who is this strange man?
He's humanity's last hope.
Yeah, don't be so dramatic. I'm just here because I'm just trying to get to my dimension.
Your dimension? You're not from around here.
Yeah, can't you tell from my weird cell shading?
Dad, something strange is going on again. And I feel like it's going to get worse as time progresses.
What are you talking about? How long have these things been around?
They're called chimeras.
Are you sure about that? We have conquered this planet, learned this strange language. What threat could possibly lie on this island?
I just get the strange feeling that these humans aren't what they appear to be. What if they have a secret weapon hidden among them?
They're squishy and frail. No human, no being on this island could possibly defeat us.
Hello? Hello? Hey, stupid alien-looking things! Over here!
What is this being? Why does he look so old?
Hey, watch who you're calling old, buddy. I've seemed to crash-landed on this island, and so far I hate it, and everyone on it. So if you could just shut up and tell me where I am. Hold on, I just realized those two lines contradict each other.
Are you threatening us?
What else would I be doing? Look, do you have some power converters lying around? I'd be able to pay you in schmeckles.
We will not be bribed by such a pathetic being with a pathetic currency. You dare mock our species. We are far superior than you.
Yawn. Hey, Oh, where's all the blood? I wanted them to go splat all over the ground. This just reminds me of some lame kid's game. Morty! Hey, Morty! Ah!
Oh, what, Rick? What do you want this time?
I just missed my grandson is all. Jeez, Morty, why you gotta bum me out like that?
You're telling me, Rick. I'm the one that got transformed into this stupid hammer. I'm sick of it. I'm sick of all of it.
Look, I told you, Morty. We entered this weird intergalactic dimension. We crash-landed here, and now we're stuck.
Okay, but how about the part where I turned into a giant hammer?
Oh, that. I just thought it'd be funny if you were a hammer. But then I lost my portal gun, and it's still funny. Take that, loser.
Jeez. How long do you think I'm going to be like this, Rick?
I don't know. Could be like a few days, 3 months. That's when the season ends, right? Oh god, I hope they don't extend the season.
Oh jeez, Rick.
All right, enough talk. Let's get going. Maybe we could grab some resources around here to make a new portal gun. Who knows? Maybe these aliens aren't dangerous.
Breaking news! These aliens are completely and totally dangerous. All of them. Like, not one single one is nice. That's right, this is Love Ranger reporting that it's been 3 months since aliens have made contact with our little island and have now begun to act hostile to some of us. There are weird hippies going around stating that aliens are our friends, but it's important to—
Aliens are our friends! They've only started to attack because Io is kidnapping and taking them! Aliens have feelings too!
Hey, aren't you that girl that did the crop circles at Farmer Steele's house?
You can't prove anything!
Well, there you have it, folks. That girl is a nut job. Let's see if we can grab a more sane person to interview. Oh, hey, look! Excuse me, miss. What is your name?
Sunny?
Well, actually, the sun is currently being blocked off by the giant mothership. But anyways, what's your take on the alien creatures invading our planet?
They're not invading anything. They're merely visiting. So why don't we just let them?
Oh, you're another one of those people.
Hey man, you asked for my opinion. I'm just being honest. I'd rather be with the aliens than on this boring planet. Any further questions?
Nope, that's all I got for you.
All right, see you, man.
No, they're not monsters. These aliens are our friends. How could someone be so cruel as to destroy this new alien life?
That's right, Morty. Destroy these scummy alien plants. Ha! Cute, my butt cheeks, am I right? You like how I censored myself?
Ow!
Hey! What do you think you're doing, old man?
Destroying alien life? What does it look like?
Oh, whoa! Hey, I'm Morty. It's nice to meet—
Yeah, nobody cares about your stupid love development, Morty.
Whoa!
Now, who are you again?
I'm Sunny, and I'm here to stop you from destroying those alien plants.
Oh, you're one of those hippie, edgy girls. I don't believe in humans. Whoa, look at me. I'm different. I don't want to be like other humans on this Earth. Now, newsflash, we're all gonna die. Most of you probably sooner, so none of this actually matters.
What is your problem, old man?
My problem is that everyone annoys me, my grandson won't shut up, and I just want to go home and watch some Gazorpa Zorpa Field. Is that too much to ask?
Excuse me.
Hmm?
I'm going to have to ask the both of you to step off that alien field there.
Oh great, who called in the men in black? I'm not listening to anything you fools say, unless you're Will Smith. Then you can tell me anything and I'll listen.
What seems to be the problem?
We don't know the dangers that thing has. What it possesses, it could harm you.
Hold on. You work for IO, don't you? That weird organization that's been showing up?
What the heck is an IO?
This does not concern you at all. I'm merely giving you this warning.
Thanks, but I didn't ask.
Fine. Suit yourself then, old man.
You know, I was a little mean to her. But gotta say, she is hot.
A little mean?
All right, boys. Talk to me.
More of those news guys have been hounding at us.
Any of them get in?
Of course not. Thankfully, Joey here was able to scare them off.
Well, looks like I made the right choice hiring you.
All part of the job description, ma'am. I aim to please.
And you certainly did. Looking at those tattoos, I thought you'd be siding with the aliens.
Are these? Nah, I'll consider myself to be a hunter. For those of the unknown.
Yep. Joey here is an experienced warrior. Has credentials in taking on Bigfoot, Chupacabra, some pancake character, and a banana man.
Two banana men.
Oh, right. Sorry. Two banana men.
Good to know. We'll keep in touch.
Thank you, ma'am. By any chance, is there any possibility you can allow me access inside?
Why would you want access inside?
Just want to know what I'm protecting.
Unfortunately, what's underneath this farm is exclusive access only to the Imagine Order organization. Sorry, but you're only a hired gunman. Is that going to be a problem with you?
No, of course not.
Good, didn't think so. Now, there's no further questions or comments, then I say we're all good to go, ma'am.
Oh, and Bronson?
Yes, ma'am?
Take us inside. So, no news reporter has come to the building, correct?
That's right, ma'am.
Good. Ugh, they'd have a field day if they knew you were experimenting on those things.
Why can't they understand we're trying to help humankind? Those things are gonna blow us all up if we don't do anything.
You're preaching to the choir, Bronson. Unfortunately for us, we don't have anything to defeat them. They're far too advanced for our kind.
That's why we got the world's smartest man to arrive.
Did you take him by force, or did you ask nicely?
We crashed his ship.
Oh, so you went with a nice option. That's good to know. Where is he, and who is he?
He goes by Rick Sanchez. Old, mean, but he is a genius. I think he was with his grandson when we brought his spaceship down.
Huh. I'll be sure to keep my eyes out for them. Any sign of John Jones?
Not yet. We'll keep looking for him, though.
It's been 3 months since the aliens came and no sign of him. I wouldn't be surprised if the idiot got himself abducted by those things.
What should we do about him?
Not sure if there's anything we can do. First, we have to figure out how to deal with those things. And I guess it starts by finding this Rick Sanchez. He might be our only hope of getting out of this mess alive.
I'll get that search team going.
Thank you, Bronson.
Thank you, Mrs.
Doctor. It's Dr. Sloan.
Of course. My apologies. Dr. Sloan. Just a bit confusing with your disguise and all.
Ah, that's right. Guess I don't need it while I'm down here.
Okay, finally finished. Hopefully now, with this device, I'll be able to construct the first portal humanity has ever seen! Ha 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 ha!
I heard evil genius laughter. Tell me the good news, Rick. Did you make a breakthrough?
Oh, Diane. I was just messing with another one of my wacky ideas. You know how I am.
Charming? Humble? Caring?
No, you're talking about yourself, babe. How's Beth?
She just woke up from her nap.
Perfect. Why don't we go get some ice cream together? Maybe afterwards we could take her to the new Avengers Academy.
Avengers Academy? You really mean it?
I do. Here, I'll get the car started.
Oh, Rick, that sounds wonderful. I'm sure Beth will be excited.
Go on and grab Beth. Come on.
We don't want the ice cream to melt.
Hold on. You're all...
Diane! Beth! No!
Oh my goodness. I am so, so sorry about that. You poor human. You must be in great pain.
Yo, bro! Check this out! I'm Spaceship Rick! You said this thing was for kids?
Yes. On our home planet. Could you focus, please? You were explaining your history with interdimensional teleportation. Our species have been longing for such a device.
Uh-huh. And what do I get out of it?
I gave you that UFO.
Oh, yeah. All right, where was I?
You had just promised to take Beth and Diane to Avengers Campus when suddenly a... Hold on. Avengers Campus was just recently opened. You said this was years ago.
Ah, shoot, you got me. But seriously, how cool is that animatronic Spider-Man?
So cool.
Rick, get me out of here!
Hold on. My stupid grandson wants attention. What? What do you want, Morty?
I'm suffocating in your tiny pocket.
You're a hammer, Morty. Good hammers don't talk.
Your grandson's a hammer?
Yeah, what of it? Go judge someone else. Have you looked in the mirror? You stupid ugly looking alien thing.
Hey Rick, maybe don't be, you know, like mean to him. He's probably got like a family too, you know. He seems like a nice guy.
Yeah, I'm a nice guy.
You're the type of guy that will probably point a gun at me the second I turn my back to you.
Come on, Rick. Be a bit more sympathetic. You're just projecting your own insecurities to others, like you always do.
Yes, you seem to be in pain. What's that word, wubba lubba dub dub?
I stopped saying that after those kids at McDonald's made that saying uncool. Anyways, let's go, Morty. I'm tired of this guy and his fake nice guy facade.
He's not fake. You're just a jerk, Rick. A big fat...
I'm sorry, Rick, but you mustn't leave. Not until you tell us the secret of crossing between dimensions.
You were saying, Morty?
Hey,
Glip-Glop, before you shoot me, what time is it?
1:30?
No, it's hammer time, loser!
I'm sorry! I don't want to do this!
It's like that one episode of Invincible! Okay, quick, Morty. Grab the fish sticks while I tell you about how I actually care about you from this one memory I just recalled.
Ooh!
We have brought with us today Rick Sanchez of Earth Dimension C-137. Oh, great. What did I do this time? Cause another world war? Destroy another alien planet I wasn't supposed to? Part in the Chili Bowl and Taco Bell? Nice one, C-137, Rick. Aw, thanks, E-156, Rick. I always knew you were cool. Unlike these clip-clops. Silence! C-137 Rick, you have been called to the Citadel of Ricks for crimes against alternate Ricks of the authority of the Transdimensional Council of Ricks. You realize how stupid you sound right now? Is anyone else hearing this? God, Ricks are so egotistical for making this whole stupid thing. You know as well as Rick does that we Ricks have a lot of enemies across the universe that consider Rick's genius a threat. Galactic terrors, a few subgalactic dictators, most of the intergalactic government. Just cut to the chase. Whoa, why am I here? You're here because of many Ricks that have been dying lately. Again? Don't act surprised. We know it was you that did it. Well, what? Why are you blaming me? Because you're the one that killed your wife. What? You think I killed Diane? We know you did, Rick. It's okay. This is a safe space. You can tell us anything. But if you do, know that we'll probably kill you and have to confiscate your Morty. Hold on! I may be a jerk and hate those around me, but I'd never, never in a million years would I hurt my wife. She was before I became, well, current Rick. That's hard to believe, Rick. You are the so-called Rickest Rick of us all. So you think just because I lost my wife, I must have killed her? Tell me, how many of you in the council have lost your Morty? Yeah, that's right. All of you have. E-156, Rick. Just the other day, you told me how you had to get another Morty delivered to you. Oh, thank goodness I paid for the Morty insurance. Many Mortys are lost each day. Yeah, and I don't plan on losing mine. So let me go, so I can go see my grandson. We're not going to let you go that easily, Rick. In fact, we've already decided we're confiscating your Morty. Your what? That's right. Until we solve this case of who killed all those Ricks, you are hereby imprisoned. And as for your Morty, he will be transferred over to Doofus Rick. No, not that guy. Anyone but him. I swear, Rick, I won't let you lay a hand on my Morty. I'll take you all on. The entire council. Let's go. Come on, you want a battle? Bring it. Bring it. And so, I killed a good amount of the council, grabbed you, and fled the dimension.
Wait, so that's why we're on this stupid island? Because you're a homicidal maniac?
Yeah. What of it?
Aw, oh, jeez, I don't like this, Rick.
Oh, what don't you like? I saved your spineless toothpick body because I care about you, idiot. Jeez, Morty, you're like the dumbest thing in the universe, I swear.
Hello?
Oh, gross. Anime, get it away.
Rick, be nice. How can we help you?
The Exa is going door to door looking for her lost bestie spaceman. She has not seen him in over 3 months and is worried for Spaceman.
Aw, that is so sweet.
Lame.
Don't listen to him. I think it's very sweet you're putting in all this effort looking for your friend. Maybe Rick and I could lend you a hand.
Really? Hammer Boy and Grumpy Butt will help Lexa look for Spaceman?
What? No, absolutely not. No way. If your friend's been missing for 3 months, then he's probably dead or got abducted by one of those alien ships. You ever thought of that, huh? Stupid robot?
Lexa is not stupid! She already thought Spaceman could be abducted. That is why Lexa got a job so she could save her money to buy a giant ladder to knock on the alien man's door.
I've heard enough.
Wait, Rick. She was really nice. Don't leave.
Wait! Grumpy Butt, do not run away from Lexa with Hammer Boy!
Leave us alone!
What do we have here? Some more flesh to devour? Oh, you do.
Huh?
What the?
Grumpy Butt! Look! Lexa is deploying!
Oh, gee, Rick. We gotta get her out of this one.
Why?
Because she's nice. You may have been right about the other guy, but her, she's different. I can tell, all right? Just listen to me for once if you actually care about me, old man.
Whatever. All right, I'm tired of this wacky adventure. I'm leaving.
Wait, Grumpy Butt! Lexa must thank you by sending you lots and lots of thank you cards!
Oh my god, I should have left you to die.
Grumpy Butt! Grumpy Butt! You look like the smart!
Yeah, and you look like a complete and utter useless robot. Whoa now, what do we got here? Ooh, Papa Likey! Now we're getting somewhere.
Amazing, isn't it?
Whoa, creepy stalker alert. Were you just waiting for us to walk in so you could make a cool, sinister approach toward us?
I believe we've met before.
Oh, really? I think I would have remembered someone with hair like that. Hey, the 80s called. They want their hair back.
Ring, ring!
Are you done?
No, I got a few more. Oh, what's up with the tie? Are you trying to make a fashion statement? Don't even get me started on your outfit.
You look like the SpongeBob!
Nice one, Lexa! That was sweet!
Oh, the only reason I'm tolerating all this is because you may be our only hope.
Oh, great! Here we go!
If my information is correct, you are Rick Sanchez, yes?
No, the name's Joe.
Joe?
Joe Mama! Ayo!
This is getting us nowhere. Rick Sanchez, you are hereby summoned by the Imagine Order in order to assist us and defeat the extraterrestrial beings that threaten our life.
Nah, I'm good.
Oh, I don't believe we'll be giving you a choice. Bronson, Zach.
Ugh, all right, SpongeBob, you win.
Feeble humans, let us show you our power!
Ah! Someone, help me!
Haven't you heard? In space, no one can hear you scream.
No, please! Ah!
Bleeding will get you nowhere. Now come on, you're coming with me, human. Oh, shoot!
Ah! Oh!
Kill me if they knew I wasted a precious resource.
I'm alive?
Huh? So you are. That is a relief.
Please, just let me go. I haven't done anything to wrong you guys.
No, you haven't. But others have. And therefore, your people must pay.
But there's people who are on your side too, you know? Not every human is trying to fight against you.
And that is why I will not be killing you.
You won't? Then what do you want with me? What do you want with us humans?
Because what we want is an army.
No, wait!
Rise, my Chimera brethren.
What is my purpose on this island?
Your purpose is to wipe out all humans that oppose us.
All humans? All life forms?
Just the humans. They are a plague on this world. Destroy everything provided by nature. We must show them true destruction.
True destruction. Very well. I shall set off for my mission.
Yes? What is it?
Have you begun the invasion of Sector C?
We just arrived.
Excellent. Continue as planned. I'll continue building an army.
Of course.
They call themselves Chimeras, and they just destroyed another one of Io's base. Do you understand? If we don't do something to stop them, they'll wipe us all out. Rick!
Sorry, did you say something? I was too busy being bored out of my mind! What do you think, Lexa?
SpongeBob Lady said some words Lexa could not understand.
What is it that you do not understand? Rick Sanchez, don't you care for our planet? The survival of the human race?
No, and, gross? No. I could care less if anyone on this planet dies. Find someone else to do the job. As the Canadians say, I'm oot!
SpongeBob Lady? Lexa was wondering if you have seen Lexa's friend Spaceman. She has not seen him in 3 months.
I don't know the specifics, but a lot of people are being abducted by aliens. For what is beyond me, but I too have lost some great people. Agent Jones were included.
Wait, SpongeBob Lady knows about John Jones?
What do you know about him?
Ew, gross plot development. I'm gonna go over here and make fun of your equations. Yep, you got all of them wrong. No wonder you're losing people. None of them can even pass basic physics.
Rick Sanchez, I have grown tired of you.
But you have to tolerate me because I'm your only hope. You snooze, you lose, kid.
No, I've had enough of you. We don't need your help anymore. We'll find another way to defeat these Chimeras. But as for you, you've seen too much.
Yeah, figured you'd try to kill us because we saw your fancy lab. Ooh, I'm so scared. Oh wait, no I'm not. Because I made a portal device while you were blabbering on about aliens or whatever. See ya, losers.
Wait, Grumpy Butt!
Well, that was lucky. I hadn't gotten a chance to test the device, so there was a 30% chance we could have just disintegrated.
Grumpy Butt, we must go back! She knew of John Jones!
I don't know who that is, and I also don't care to know.
John Jones is a friend of...
I said I don't care, stupid idiot robot!
Lexa is not an idiot robot! She's a smart, intellectual, beautiful girl!
Come on, Rick! I'm getting real sick and tired of you acting mean towards everyone around this island. How do you expect to get treated with hospitality around here?
I don't plan on it. If I need something, I take it. I'm not above killing, Morty. I steal from the rich and the poor. Deal with it.
But how do you expect for us to get back home when you keep being rude to everyone you meet?
Why am I getting a life lesson from my grandson? I'm seriously getting a migraine dealing with you all.
Grumpy Butt, if you do not start being nice to people, Lexa will bring you straight to the jail!
Jail? Gross. What are you, a cop? Is that your job?
Job? Oh no! Grumpy Butt, what time is it?
It's not hammer time, that's for sure. I made that joke last episode. The comments really liked that one. Ayo!
It's almost morning, Lexa. Why?
Lexa's going to be late for work! It was nice speaking with you, Hammer Boy and Grumpy Butt, but Lexa will catch up with you later before she gets the fired!
Jeez, what kind of idiotic place would hire an idiot like her? Ah, isn't this the life, Morty?
Not really, Grandpa Rick. I'm like a hammer person, and I'm in your pocket.
Not really sure how that works, to be honest.
It's my pocket dimension, Morty. Get it?
Yeah, okay. I guess that's clever and all. But still, do we have a plan to fix the whole hammer situation yet?
Quiet, Morty. I'm working on my tan.
There he is. Dr. Sloan will be pleased. Let's move in.
Up, up, up! That's close enough, amigos. Yeah, that's right. I'm not even gonna look at you while I talk. It's a total power move.
Rick Sanchez, you will come with us immediately. Io needs you.
Well, I owe you nothing. Are you really gonna interrupt an old man's beach day with his boy?
Am I the boy?
Shut up, Morty.
We will not take no for an answer. This is a matter of life and death.
Yeah, yours. I've taken entire civilizations. I think I can handle your little rinky-dink nerd crew.
That's it.
The boss wants him alive. Shoot him in the leg.
I don't think they're fooling around, Rick.
And neither am I. Rah! Surprise attack!
Take cover!
Power mode or whatever. Didn't expect that, did ya?
You're going down, old man.
No, you. Got him.
Ah!
Jeez, Rick, these guys may not be that friendly, but they are still people.
I thought we went over this, Morty. They're bureaucrats. Lackeys of the man. The universe is better off without them.
Please, Rick, no more killing. For me?
Ugh. Fine.
That's enough. Come out with your hands up, coward.
Who are you calling chicken? Wait, did you say chicken or coward? Oh, whatever. There, are you happy now, Morty?
I don't feel so.
Oh, jeez, Rick! Did you really have to do her like that?
Let me guess you liked her, too. Can you control your teenage hormones for 1 second? She's a chicken now. Deal with it.
It's not that, Rick. You can't just go around turning people into this, that, a bunch of nonsense, whatever you feel like.
Sure I can, but that's because I'm the one with the chicken gun. Speaking of which, she looks pretty good. What do you say, Morty? In the mood for fried chicken?
Rick!
Ugh, fine, come on.
Bye, miss! Sorry!
Bubba-lubba-dub-dub! Yeah, that's right, bringing it back for no reason, I don't care.
Oh, I think I got whiplash, Rick.
You don't have a neck, Morty. That'd be impossible.
This place is kind of empty, Rick.
Body actors aren't cheap, Morty. Hey, can I get some service around here?
Oof! Hey!
Welcome to Fishy Sticks!
I thought I smelled weeb.
Grumpy Pants and Hammer Boy! Lexa's happy to see you again!
Hey, Lexa! You work here too?
Yes! Lexa is the working man. All day, all night. But that is why she is paid the big bucks.
And what's that? 7 an hour?
Plus tips.
Yeah, that's not happening. Now, let's see. I'll take a number 2 and a number 7, and Morty will just have a kid's meal.
Hey!
Your stomach's as thin as a toothpick, Morty. Anything more than that could literally kill you.
Okay! Beep boop beep! Lexa has done the math! You owe Lexa $19.95!
Man, that must sting. My sandwich is worth more than an entire hour of your life. Anyways, pay the robot, Morty.
I can't even move my arms, Rick!
Oh, that's just great, Morty. Well, time to bust out the chicken gun.
Chicken gun?
Ah, time for some grub.
Governess! Get down!
Hey, what's up with you?
That is the sugar butt! He is Lexa's soulmate!
So, why are you hiding from him?
He has the big restraining order on Lexa because he is technically married to a she-devil!
Been there, done that.
Aww, if only Lexa could hold Sugarbot in her arms and squeeze him forever.
That's true love right there.
Hey, I just thought of a way we could pay you. Hey, buddy, say cheese.
What the? Ah!
Sugarbot is even cuter than before!
Thank you. At least someone appreciates my work.
I still think it's messed up.
Relax, Morty. The effects of the marketable plushie affair are only temporary. They'll probably go back to normal in a few hours, or days, or years, or well, who cares? Point is, we ate, now I'm bored. Let's go watch some TV. Yo, robot chick, you wanna come with?
After what you have done for her, how could Lexa refuse? Come along, sugar boat!
Ah, home sweet home.
Rick, this isn't our house.
It is now.
Hey, who are you? You can't just...
Okay, make yourself at home while we do some science stuff to this TV.
Time to take the load off.
You're in for a real treat, Lexa. The first time you watch interdimensional cable, it'll blow your mind.
But Lexa needs her mind to have to learn to fly spacemans.
What? No, I...
Got it. And away we go.
I swear, I was just working late at the office, honey. Promise.
Uh-huh. Then whose motor oil did I find this morning? Cause it wasn't mine, mister.
Well...
Oh! The metal birds are talking! How is this possible?
Science, that's how. I rigged the TV to access cable from other dimensions and realities. In this one, it looks like helicopters are sentient.
He doesn't love you, Jessica! He loves me!
Christine?
Aha! The truth comes out! Take this, hussy!
Next!
Greetings and welcome to Family Feud! Let's meet our first contestant, Oren!
Oren?
Boring!
Take the magic box back right now!
Jeez, okay! Don't go all HAL 9000 on me!
Oh, looks like they switched the channel back.
Ahem. You were introducing your family, Oren?
Yeah, thanks, Deadpool. This is my twin sister, Lexa.
Lexa is happy to be here, Steve!
Hey, that's cool! I didn't know you had a brother, Lexa! Lexa?
From what I understand, you had a real scare when you almost died from a psychotic ghost cowboy.
Can you go into more detail on that?
Yeah, funny story. I almost ran out of power, but...
But Lexa saved him at the last minute! That's what big sisters are for!
And now we have tighter bond than ever. Like a real family.
Well, that's just great. I sure hope there's not an alternate reality version of Lexa
whose brother actually did die, watching this right now, and wondering if she could have done things differently. Because that would just be a huge buzzkill.
Youch.
Lexa has to go.
Oh, jeez, Rick. Should we do something?
But Morty, Gazorpazorp Field is almost on.
Rick.
Oh, fine. Hey, kid. You all right?
There was a way to save him. And Lexa couldn't find it.
Don't beat yourself up. Like I said, there are infinite realities out there. In a handful of those, you got lucky and saved Orange somehow.
Oren.
Right. Morty and I have messed up big sometimes, too. And you know how we come to terms with it?
How?
We didn't. We just hopped dimensions to one where we didn't mess up. Easy fix. You know, if I get a portal gun working, I could send you to a reality where your brother's still alive. Wouldn't even skip a beat.
You could? But what about the people here?
Who cares about them? You'd get what you want, and that's all that matters.
Thank you for the offer. But what happened to Oren? Happened. Lexa has to live with that. But she will not let it happen again. Lexa's friends need her help here, in this reality. She will not abandon them, no matter how long it takes.
I must say, Marigold, you've come a long way with driving.
Yeah. Well, I learned from the best, you know?
Indeed. That reminds me. Whatever happened with that Rick and Morty?
Wubba-lubba-dub-dub! Ha-ha! That'll show them! They're not that important! Ha! Points for Rick! Woo! Yeah! I can say anything right now because of scene transition! I hate everybody! So see, I told you there was a reality where I killed the both of you, again.
I could drive.
She could drive,
Yeah! Hey! You want to see the dimension where Lexa takes over the world? It's pretty juicy.
Wait, you were telling us your history on this island.
Yeah? So what? I thought you'd get bored by now.
I must get a full understanding if we are to do something about it. Please, Rick, if you could tell me, where is Agent Jones?
It's Rick Sanchez! He's invading the facility!
Take him out! Hurry!
You wanted me, you... got me, Bloop Doggles. Sorry if that was offensive. Jeez, I expected more from that.
Rick, what are we doing back here exactly? We were just in the mothership? What good does it serve to coming back here?
I told you, Morty. That stupid spacecraft was nothing but a huge stupid maze. Word around these guys is they got a map to that ship. Once we get it, we can go home. Got it?
Yeah, I got it. You just don't have to yell all the time, you know? You could try and be nicer about it.
Morty, I've never been nice in my life. You think I'm just gonna listen to some 10-year-old kid telling me to be nice?
I'd like to, and I'm not 10. I'm in high school. Why can't you pay attention to anyone but yourself?
Because nothing and no one in this universe matters. You got that? Don't let anyone else tell you anything. That's main character syndrome. You got that? You should always act like a main character. You and me, Morty. Rick and Morty on Fortnite Island. 100 years, Rick and Morty. RickandMortyFortnite.com.
Tell me, what are you going on about, mate?
I was having some bonding time with my grandson.
How sad. The poor old man thinks the hammer is his grandson. You ain't gonna even look at me?
Why waste my time? As if you're gonna shoot.
Oh? And why are you so confident I won't shoot?
Rick, not this again. Did you clone us again?
Shut up, Morty. I know you won't shoot. You know why? Because you need me. You need me because I'm the only genius around here that can- Ah! Jeez! You actually did it! I was bluffing! What is wrong with you?
Rick, are you okay?
No, I'm not okay! Morty, does it look like I'm okay? I just got shot in the foot!
I thought you just cloned us, like last time!
What, you think I just reused the same trick twice? You think I'm so low, Morty? Gotta say, I'm quite offended.
Alright, that's enough out of you, old man.
Take that, alien scum!
Huh? Alien? How do you know about that?
Are you serious? The alien tattoos, the eye patch, the accent? It's like you're screaming alien. Now go on! Go ahead and reveal yourself before I shoot. Zooey! Mama!
I feel so humiliated to be caught by such a scrawny old man.
Hey, don't put yourself down. I'm only the smartest man in the universe.
Grandpa Rick, can we focus on getting back home?
Not now, Morty. Grandpa's in love right now.
What is this love you speak of? And can you eat it?
Haha, no. So tell me, what's a cute alien girl such as yourself doing around this island?
I'm here to blow it all up, but I am conflicted.
Why is that? Because you met me?
No. Because I've revealed myself to two humans already.
Yeah! Hey, what gives?
You are a human. Humans are to be annihilated. Do you not understand?
Whoa! I'm on your guy's side!
Humans don't get to be on our side. Goodbye, Earthling. Why am I so tired all of a sudden?
Hey! Thanks for the help, mister! But how did you, do that?
Don't tell me. Are you an alien too?
I guess there's no point in hiding.
What is the matter? Scared, Earthling?
No! You look so cute!
Huh?
Oh my gosh, I just want to shrink you down in size and put you in my pocket! it! So what's the reason for you all visiting us? I mean, Earthlings are pretty cool. Was it the anime? It was the anime, wasn't it? You don't have to tell me. Listen, new best friend. You, me, and Rox. We should go do typical Earthlings around the island and see how you react to doing normal people things. It'd be so fun. What do you think?
I think you should take a nap.
Hey, is that the thing from Star Trek?
She seems innocent enough, energetic, and perhaps stupid, but innocent at the least. I shall leave her be. And so I went to continue my patrol around the I.O. Huh? When did we get here?
Well, you were distracted by that flashback. I took us to this dance club so we could, like, you know, dance. Come on, do the Rick dance with me. It's copyright, so we have to use this ska song. Hey, Marshmallow, turn it up. Oh, yeah. Come on, shoot, I didn't get your name. Dance with me. Come on. You didn't have to do my homie Marshmallow like that.
This is a waste of time, Earthling. I must get back to my mission to infiltrating I.O.
Oh, you're trying to invade those guys. Haha, what'd they do to upset your species?
They have captured and enslaved my people. I must gain access to the inside of I.O. and find proof they have our species captured. Do you think you can help?
Where am I? Huh? Dr. Sloan?
Welcome back, John Jones.
Hey, how did I get here? Last I remember, I was... Guys?
Breakpoint, what is that thing?
Whatever it is, it's trouble. Hurry, before...
Abducted by aliens? Dr. Sloan, are you an alien?
I can assure you I am not. We have a lot to discuss.
We do?
Yes. First, what were you thinking trying contacting the Seven? Have you lost your mind?
He's frozen by that large spire.
The spire has been destroyed. Last we saw, he fell in a pool.
Well, maybe he drowned.
John, I found you inside a pod up in that mothership.
Wow, you actually went up there to rescue me? You must have really missed me, huh, Dr. Sloan?
Shut your face for a second!
Okay.
When I went up there, you were with two other figures. Who were those, John?
They were, friends. Friends.
One of them had the same logo as the Seven. You're still working with them, aren't you?
Ugh! What else am I supposed to do? Let all of reality die? I saved these people!
They're not people! And this isn't our dimension. Look. Wait here. I'll see.
See what? If the others from I.O. won't kill me, I'm dead if I stay here.
I'm sure I can put in a good word for you.
Yeah, whatever.
So, did Midas say anything about me?
Huh? Why would he say anything about you?
Ugh, never mind. Don't go anywhere.
Sure. Don't worry. I have no plans of going anywhere. As if I can.
Okay, Morty. We have to find a captive alien so that the blue-haired girl will fall in love with me.
Huh? What the?
Hey, who goes there? Ah, a boring office worker.
Ah, creepy old guy.
Ah!
Ah, screaming hammer.
Hey, this guy looks alien enough. Oh, what do you think, Morty?
He looks like a human, Rick. Just a normal-looking, boring human.
Eh, he'll do.
Hey, what are you doing? Where'd you get that microwave?
Okay, Jones. I've spoken with... Someone find John Jones. Kill him on sight.
Where'd you take us?
Hey, where'd she go? Wait, don't leave!
Who are you telling not to leave? What's going on here?
Shut up and lead!
What?
Lead!
Okay, fine. Just stop yelling at me. It hurts my feelings.
Oh my God, you're worse than Jerry.
Who's Jerry?
Hey, cute alien chick that reminds me of Avatar.
The Last Airbender?
No, idiot, the one with the blue people.
Oh, yeah, she does kind of look like them. Yeah.
Hmm? What is this so-called Avatar?
Never mind that. Look, I brought an alien present, straight from the Imagination Ordeal, whatever they're called.
That is not an alien. That's just a boring-looking office worker.
I'm not boring.
What? But they had him on a stage and everything. Look, maybe he's not an alien, but I'm just trying to find love. Don't you see the spark between us? Huh? You, me, Cancun, or Cabo? I heard that place is really nice in Mexico.
What is a Mexico?
Whatever. You're too stupid. I'm out of here. Let's go, Morty.
What just happened? You're an alien?
Sorry, mate. I've got a mission. And you know far too much.
What? Don't tell me you're gonna kill me!
Freeze! John Jones! We have direct orders from Dr. Sloan to execute you right here, right now!
Yeah, same.
Come on!
This is the life. Man, I forget how nice and peaceful it was, without an annoying pipsqueak of a grandson every now and then. I should do this more often. Just me, my spaceship, and this random cardboard box that no one is totally hiding in. Yep, just an empty cardboard box.
Hey, Grandpa Rick?
Yeah, gross kid, shoot it!
Wait, Rick, it's me!
How do you know my name? Who sent you?
Rick, it's me, Morty, stop!
Huh? Morty, you solid snaked me. I never get solid snaked. I can't believe it. What are you doing here?
You told me we had to run away for some reason.
Yeah, and I also said, stay where you were. I was going to come and get you, idiot.
Okay, whatever. Can you just turn me back, okay? I don't like being a hammer. Why am I a hammer anyways?
Because, Morty, I always thought you were a tool. A useless one at that.
You don't have to be so mean about it. Now come on, just turn me back, please.
Later, Morty. I'm still upset about the solid snake jump scare. You trying to give your grandpa a heart attack?
Yeah, well, maybe I am. What are we doing, Rick, huh? What did you do this time? Are we going to run away from our dimension again? Will we have to start new lives?
Relax, Morty. We just have to lay low for a bit. Look, we're in this new dimension. So we're going to chill out on this nice-looking, peaceful island, where nothing bad happens.
Huh? That's not one of ours. Intruder! We got here first! We're invading this planet! Yeah!
And so we crash-landed here. Everything would have been fine if Morty here didn't destroy my portal gun.
What was I supposed to do, Rick? I'm a hammer! My whole head weighs more than my body! This is all your fault!
Always blaming others, never taking responsibility for yourself. So anyways, you think you can help us?
Excuse you. So let me get this straight. You turned your grandson into a hammer, crash-landed onto this island, broke your portal device that can take you home, and now you want to use this location for your lab experiments?
Yeah, what part didn't you get?
I think I'll pass. I've got a lot of things on my mind lately.
Yeah, no kidding. Those tattoos just scream, pay attention to me. Let me guess, daddy issues? Your mom's dead? A loved one died. A loved one died, didn't they?
Hey, what is your problem? You can forget using this place for your inventions now.
She didn't say no. I got it on the nose, didn't I?
Rick, be nice. Listen, miss.
You can call me Jules.
Rick, look, I know my grandpa may be the most insensitive, ungrateful, rude.
Yeah, Morty, she gets the point.
But I'm sure there's some way we can repay you. Please, I just want to go back home.
Sorry, but no.
Oh, so are you single?
Morty!
I don't want to talk about it.
Jesus, Morty, you insensitive swine. Much apologies, Crystal, or whatever useless gem you were named. We'll take our business somewhere else.
Good. I hope we never run into each other.
Yeah, whatever. Come on, Morty. Maybe we can try getting back into that mothership again.
Ooh, you think we can let out that one guy that looks like the Mandalorian?
Wait! You know where the Mandalorian is?
Isn't he a TV show?
Shut up, Morty. Yes, we know of this Mandalorian. And yes, we know where he is.
Just, who are you, old man?
Just an inventor who's explored multiple realities and have seen just about everything there is to see. But yes, let's strike a deal, shall— Oh my god, it's Snowball!
Hey! Who's this funny looking man?
Wow! He can talk just like Snowball, too! This island may be even more wacky than our place, Rick!
Hey, who are you? And who created your function of talking?
Why, Jules did! She's the greatest inventor ever!
Uh-huh.
Anyways, mister, I was overhearing how rude you were to Jules.
Oh god, a white knight.
Simp!
Ooh, I always wanted to be a knight! But I also wanted to know what you were doing here. Why were you running away from your reality?
Ah, I thought you'd never ask. Flashback! So there I was, fighting against armies of Ricks in the Citadel of Ricks.
Citadel of Ricks? What is that?
Too long to explain. Watch my origin story for that. Pretty much, I was being framed for killing other Ricks.
And so, you started killing other Ricks.
Duh. Hello? You reached Rick.
Rick? What's going on? I hear shooting and screaming.
Kill the Rick! He must pay for his crimes! What's your point?
Rick, are you fighting with yourself again?
It doesn't matter, Morty. But what does matter is we need to get you out of here for a bit.
Out of where?
Out of this dimension. I'll explain everything when I go pick you up.
Rick, is everything going to be okay? I'm scared.
Everything will be okay. I won't let anything bad happen to you. Grandpa's gotta go now.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Rick.
Evil Hammer Morty. Ugh, I should have known you were behind this.
That's right. I was the one that's been plotting the killings of all the Ricks across the dimensions.
Why? What did Rick do? And why me specifically?
Because Rick, you're the Rickest Rick of them all. And in you just defending yourself, you helped me kill more Ricks. Ha 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 ha!
I hate being tricked to kill.
Too bad. I'll be giving you 24 hours to flee. Run away from the Citadel of Ricks. After that, though, I'll be sending out all of the Ricks to come after you.
You're John Wicking me? Gah, I hate when people do that. All right, punk, you're on. I'm gonna hide in a place you'll never find me. And then, I'm gonna come after you. You hear me?
Instead of talking, you should be running. TikTok, TikTok.
Yeah, shut up. You Zoomers are obsessed with that app. Ugh, if there's anything I hate more than Rick's, it's Morty's. And so now I need to repair my ship, invent a new portal gun, and dip. But pretty easy if you ask me. Oh, when did this guy get here?
Is he talking about me?
Wait, actually after looking at you for a bit, you remind me of my pal Squanchy when he squanched his last squinch.
Thank you?
Hold on, we're not finished yet. What do you know about the Mandalorian?
What is this, 20 bazillion questions or something? I'm gonna go find some food around here. Or we can talk later.
Bye, Jules. I'll miss you.
That man seems very off. Why are you putting up with him?
Because he knows something about the Mandalorian. Maybe he knows something about the disappearance of my father, too.
Midas. He has been gone for a long time. What about your mom?
Still no luck. But I'm trying, Meowsles. It's just getting harder as each day goes by.
Well, we have to take it one step at a time. Give that Rick guy some time. Then we'll ask him about where the others may be.
Yeah. Just hope everyone's okay.
One of the pods was empty.
Did they escape?
Impossible! It was but a simple man. They must have been taken.
And about the other four?
There. Still intact.
Good. I have a strong feeling about these four.
Oh, and what good would simple puny humans have for us?
These four were fighting utilizing energy not common in humans. This one may not even be one anymore.
So you plan to harness their abilities? And for what? Yourself?
Huh. Do you think of me as that self-centered? No. I plan on researching these four, so all of our Chimera army can possess their abilities.
And what are their abilities?
These four? No. These two are what I believe to be gods among men.
Gods among men? How long will the process take?
I can get them up and running as soon as possible. But it was this one that called attention to our species. This specimen's abilities is far more advanced than our technology.
Yes, if it wasn't for the Spire, we would not have found them. This is terrible! They've stolen what we've worked hard to obtain!
No matter. We still have him.
When will the experiment be over? Surely we must be close!
We need more time. But do not worry. We shall begin to send in the scout chimeras. They shall buy us more time.